So it has been 3 years since Logitech launched the G933. Wait, this is not it. This is the 933, pretty decent wireless gaming headset with fantastic surround sound, but a poor microphone. So, 3 years later, the G935 is here. They have equipped it with new drivers, but everything else remains pretty much identical to the original. So, good people, is this thing worth the upgrade? I need to move. This was not happening 5 minutes ago before I started recording, okay? Now, with every Logitech briefing we get, they tell us it's their most innovative product, they're really proud of it. And while the 935 is their flagship gaming headset, you know, I find the audio quality is to be better than the 933. The microphone has improved as well, but I was hoping they would take it into a different direction physically. And I'll tell you why right after this. Oh, come on, what are you doing? Don't sit on the keyboard.
Sorry, I didn't realize. It's so low profile.
Did you bring the stuff?
I sure did. It's so compact.
It's a good tool, trust me. This brushed aluminum plate, floating half-height keycaps, MX Cherry low profile switches, a Type-C connection,
and comes in different sizes too.
The Cooler Master SK series. Careful not to miss them. Links below.
And as usual, everything will be linked in the description below if you want to check out any of these products we talk about in the video. Thank you very much. All right, so first let's start with the price. The G935 sells for $169, which is steep, but it is the same price of the G933. So price-wise, it has remained the same. Now, physically, nothing much has changed. The headset still feels and sounds plastic. You know, the glossy plastic on the ear cups is still present, which is kind of nasty once you just handle the headset. The magnetic ear cups on the sides have been slightly redesigned, but they're still customizable and they fit on the 933, so the exactly the same format. And on the left ear cup, we still have that USB compartment, so you can carry the receiver with you. But the positive change here are the ear cups. No longer do we have that harsh bathing suit material like we saw on the 933. Here we have this leather material that has better isolation. It maintains a little bit more of that deeper bass, and on skin contact, it's just a lot more comfortable. Because the drivers are new and the internals of the ear cups are new, the actual driver wall has now been flattened slightly versus the 933 that had a bit more curve. And you guys probably never noticed this, but I have different size ears. So my left ear is slightly bigger and it makes contact with that internal wall because it doesn't have that much of a groove like we had on the 933, which I would say is a downgrade in comfort for me personally versus the 933. And it's also, the new headset is 5 grams heavier. Not significant, but I was hoping, you know, they could reduce the weight of this design and also make the internal wall slightly more curved so that your ears will not make contact. I was also hoping we'd see a slight redesign in the frame itself because look at it, it's still incredibly bulky and just way too wide, especially compared to something like the Corsair HS70 or the HyperX Cloud Flight that are a lot more low profile and low key versus the G935. This is a gaming headset through and through. Now let's talk about the LightSync branding in the name. So this beautiful RGB strip at the back and the G logo on the side can be controlled individually. And they look awesome. It was a great introduction in the 933 3 years ago, but right now they're at the back. So for the user, they're invisible. And for the audience, they're also invisible. So functionally, they make no sense. I was kind of hoping they would reposition the LEDs to the front so that at least the audience could enjoy some RGB goodness, but also having the illumination on tanks your battery life. So I lost 30% in 3 hours. So you're looking at maximum 10 hours of usage with the LEDs on versus losing 20% of battery life in 3 hours with the RGB illumination off. So not that significant. However, you still should turn off all the RGB stuff to prolong your battery life. So you're looking at, I don't know, maybe like 12 hours maximum usage with this headset with the LEDs off, which is kind of disappointing. Again, 3 years in development and their battery life with their mice is so good that I was kind of hoping that we would see something like that on the 935 too. We do have a bunch of controls on the left ear cup, a volume wheel, which I don't like. It's way too sensitive. So like a single swipe of the wheel, you know, changes the volume by 30%. So there is no precise adjustment. We have a mic mute switch and 3G buttons that are programmable, which is awesome, and a power on off switch. You charge this thing via micro USB at the bottom, and there's also the 3.5 millimeter analog connection, which means the headset can also be used in wired mode. And just make sure to turn off the headset when using that 3.5 millimeter connection. But interestingly, they have removed the 3.5 millimeter connection on the actual USB receiver, like we saw on the 933. Now the USB receiver with the 935 is just the receiver. You cannot plug anything into it. And despite all the negatives surrounding the physical characteristics, the pointless RGB illumination, the really loose scroll wheel, for example, and the poor battery life, this is the best wireless gaming headset I have ever heard. In comparison to my HyperX Cloud Flight, the 935 completely destroys it in clarity in the bass, just so much more fullness. The HyperX Cloud Flight sounds kind of tinny and harsh in comparison. So whatever new drivers they've installed here absolutely delivers a fantastic audio experience, not just from a stereo perspective, but you know, I've been really a huge fan of the surround sound that we get on the 933, and that carries forward with the 935. And I've actually started to enable surround sound with the 935 because it doesn't necessarily distort too much of your directional awareness. It enlarges the audio space, but you still get like, you know, if it's a footstep, it sounds like just like a footstep it would in stereo mode, but slightly wider sound stage basically. So your positional awareness is still intact, and that is something that is kind of difficult to achieve with your standard surround sound modes, and the overall audio experience is 9 out of 10.
All right, so this is what the new microphone sounds like. They went from a 4 millimeter capsule on the 933 to 6 millimeters. So it sounds richer, it sounds a bit fuller versus the 933, but still it sounds quite a bit compressed and not as natural as you would, you know, hear from a regular wired headset, but definitely an improvement over 933. So this is what the 3-year-old G933 sounds like. It's definitely more muffled versus the 935, but I mean, the difference between them is 3 years, so I was hoping for even better improvement on the 935. So this is what the HyperX Cloud Flight sounds like. It's definitely better than the 933, but it's not as loud or clear as the 935. And so finally, here's the Corsair HS70. So this one's kind of in the middle pack. It's better than the 933, but it's not as good as the HyperX Cloud Flight, and definitely not as good as the 935.
I really like what they've done with the software. G-Hub is intuitive to use. We have nice big percentage indicator for the battery life underneath the product, which is excellent. You can customize color and light sync to other, you know, Logitech peripherals. You can reassign what those G buttons do, which is awesome. I just leave mine at default to enable surround sound and toggle between the different sound modes. And of course, the equalizer controls are awesome if you want extra treble, extra bass, or something in the mid range. I really like the default profile and cinematic for a little extra like high-end boost, because the bass here is tight enough and I don't feel like I need extra. And so in conclusion, you know, it's really good to see the G935 establish itself as like this dominant product in wireless audio. It sounds way better than anything I've heard in this wireless category, but they definitely need to do something, you know, with the physical characteristics and perhaps go the G Pro route. Like if they had the G Pro wireless headset, but with these drivers, I would love that. Beautiful design, simple, great aesthetics, no RGB, but of course they have to go the really high-end route that incorporates everything else so they can trickle down these drivers into lower tier wireless gaming headsets. I'm hoping we'll see that soon, because like it's a good headset, but it's not for me physically. Comfort wise, it's perfectly fine. Wear these for hours, you know, a little bit of heat accumulation inside the ear cups, but otherwise it's a good pair. But guys, let me know what you think of the Logitech G935 in the comments, and what do you think about the microphone quality as well. I'm happy to see them improved it, and also Logitech has purchased Blue, so we will see what the microphone quality will be like for future Logitech headsets. So I'm hoping we'll see something sooner rather than later. All right, I'm Dmitry, thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next video, and all the links for all the my favorite wireless headsets and non-wireless are linked in the description below. Thanks so much, see you later.